I'm Jim Thomas. Our question of the week is, can I grow blueberries in Central Texas? Blueberries are one of the most difficult crops to grow in with our soil and water here. Blueberries, most species, were evolved in southeastern United States or in other parts of North America where the soils are quite acid. Blueberries like a soil pH between 4.5 and 5, and that's simply not what we have here. And the reason that's important is because blueberries are one of the few plants that have no root hairs. They're entirely dependent on a mycorrhizal affiliation, a fungus that infects the plant that actually benefits both organisms. The blueberry plant feeds the fungus, and the fungus acts as a root hairs for absorption of water and nutrients. So when you plant blueberries in our soils and use our water, the mycorrhizal fungi simply die, and a blueberry plant will show you every single nutritional deficiency known to plant kind. Again, blueberries like high organic matter, they like acid soils, they cannot tolerate water that has calcium or sodium in it. So if you really want to grow a blueberry, there are ways to get around this. You can probably do them best in a container. The ideal media for blueberries is half sand and half peat moss. The pH of peat is between 5 and 5.5, and the high organic matter is perfect for the growth of these mycorrhizal fungi. You don't really need to worry about inoculating these plants. They come inoculated with this fungus from the nursery. You simply want to create an environment where they'll survive. The other thing that's going to be a necessity is the collection and use of solely rainwater. Using city water that is high in calcium will simply kill the mycorrhizal fungi, and the blueberry plant won't survive. Our plant of the week are pears. The question we commonly get is, what varieties can we grow in different parts of the state? Now, if you're growing in the eastern part of the state, over near Beaumont, where you get high rainfall, your fire blight tolerance is going to be absolutely essential. So if you're growing in Central Texas, you can get away with less fire blight tolerance but higher fruit quality. So for the eastern part of the state, things like kefir, Maxine, Moonglow are probably the ideal varieties, whereas in Central Texas, Ayers, Warren, and LeConte are probably higher quality, and you don't need to worry as much about fire blight. We also get questions about, do I need to worry about chill hours with pears? Most pears adapted to the southern part of the United States are relatively low chilling. 450, 500 hours is plenty. So we get plenty of chilling in most of our areas. Because they're a little slow to bloom, we rarely get problems with spring frost. The other question is, do I need another pear for pollination? And the answer is yes. Two pears bloom at the same time are ideal for fruit set. We'd love to hear from you. Head on over to our website, klru.org/CTG, to send us your questions and pictures from your garden.